fight Owens fight is the same thing as never give up. Like, I'm talking to you, buddy. And he's like, I got all these colors. You want to make fun of all the gear, but I don't do it for you. I do for that little boy. People like that little boy right there with a never give up sign. Oh. And they show the kid's crying and says, I beat cancer because thank you, John Cena. Never go. And I'm sitting there bawling my eyes out.
Oh my God.
I mean, you think Keith fucking Lee is gonna get me there?
Lime, duh.
Out there, kids, grab your coat. It's been a minute, I know, now I'm back to Rome. Looking for the antidote to crack the code. Pretty vivid, I admit it, I'm in classic mode. Don't need pity given to me, but I can't condone. Talking down to me, I'ma have to crack your nose for cracking jokes. I'm looking for the map to hope, you see that?
Been making a whole lot of changes. Wrote a song about that, you should play it. I get scared when I walk on these stages. I look at the crowd and see so many faces. Yeah, that's when I start to get anxious. That's when my thoughts can be dangerous. That's when I put on my makeup and drown in self-hatred. Forget what I'm saying and where the beat go? Oh, ain't that something? Drums came in, you ain't see that coming. Hands on my head, can't tell me nothing. Got a taste of the fame, it'll pump my stomach. Throw it back up like I don't want it. Wipe my face, clean up my vomit. OCD trying to push my buttons, I said don't touch it. Now y'all done it. I can be critical, never typical. Intricate with every syllable, I'm a criminal. Intimate but never political, pretty visual. Even if you hate it, I make it feel like you're in it though. You call me what you want, but never call me forgettable. Leave you deep in thought, I can never swim in the kiddie pool. Waited, I've been thinking the cinematic is beautiful. And I don't know if I'm making movies or music videos. Videos.
Yeah. Welcome to the post Elimination Chamber, Cal. I don't know what we call this. Post-mortem. This is the chill set. This isn't a recap. Go to fucking cage side seats. You want to recap? This is just the fucking bros doing it up, having a great time talking chamber daddies. Wow, a lot happened tonight. Many would say not a lot happened tonight. They'd both be right. The chamber was disappointing in some ways, but surprising and fun in other ways. We had fun. We watched in the Calzoom Thunderdome with all the patrons. Appreciate all the patrons who are at the Calzoom Thunderdome level, making all these pay-per-views are a blast to watch together. And it was a good fucking time. Anyway, I'm here. Let me introduce the room here. I'm here with the super Mark, the Markitect, Mr. Nick Tullo. What up?
Yo, it's 10:33 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. It's your boy, Tiptoe Tullo. What's going on, Dan? What's up, Shebiro?
Yo,
what's up, Skylar?
I'm introducing.
Sort of taking the wind out of the intros, but I love it.
Well, this is the post. This is the post pay-per-view. Thunderdome, Tullo. Yeah, I think 8 hot dogs tonight. He's a little drunk.
Yeah, 2 chili dogs, baby.
But coming from us from Toronto, Vancouver, Mr. Perfect, Skylar Astin. It was a joke from the Thunderdome.
Wow. I've been here for 33 years.
Wow. What flavor is that?
What flavor?
Fine.
Oh, bubbly. Skylar. God, bubbly. You know,
where are they,
Skylar,
on the toxicity ratings?
After what we saw tonight with The Miz becoming the champion, I think it's time to bring back... welcome to the most muscle listened to podcast. Welcome to
Cow TV.
Welcome to the most muscle listened to podcast in podcast history. Welcome to Cow TV.
Ow. Welcome to the most muscle listened to Cow.
Nope.
Skylar, who is the podcast in WWE history. Welcome to Cow TV.
Yeah, and thank you, Skylar. Miz the new champion, and the Cow champion, Jason Shebiro, is here too.
What's up?
Yeah,
pleasure to be here.
Jason, you're always allowed on here because you are the current Cow champion, but you know, is what it is. Anyway, let's talk about the Elimination Chamber. We are coming off of it. I mean, fuck, we should start from the finish, right?
Sure.
The Miz cashes in successfully his Money in the Bank briefcase to become the 2-time heavyweight WWE heavyweight champion. Did he hold it more than that, like even for a short period? I think it's just 2 times, right? He had those 2 title reigns, right?
I think I just saw a crazy stat.
Am I wrong that he had it? Did he have it a 3rd time for a short amount of time?
I think it's 2 times. Maybe.
I don't remember.
No, but, 2 times.
But he basically, this will be his 2nd run as the champion, essentially, right?
Correct.
And it's about 10 years coming. Guys, how do you feel about Miz cashing in and winning the fucking title tonight at the Chamber? A, did you expect it? B, are you excited for it? And C, do you think we see what do you think they do with Miz? Do you think Lashley's involved? Where do we go from here? It's kind of this was a surprise
questions.
To me. This was a surprise to me.
Well, I love that Miz is champion. I love that he successfully cashed in the briefcase. I think that feels good. It feels weird because he always is going to feel a little bit below the level, right? Of like, you know, he's not Drew, right? He's not Lesnar. So, right. But he does something very important and very good and very interesting, and I like it. I personally would love to see if there's some sort of cahootsiness between the Hurt Business and Miz. Like if Miz now rolls with the Hurt Business as his muscle, that works for me. That's very cool because between MVP and Miz, that's a lot of great jaw work right there. So that could be cool. And I think it was Pit Boss, AJ Pittner said, Miz with all the corporate synergies. I think he called it corporate synergies between the Peacock launch and him being a mouthpiece for NBC as WWE is coming in. And it just makes
he's
sense.
He's a big reality star on USA for them.
Right.
He's a handsome, hot dude. He's incredibly charismatic. He easily could host like a Kelly and Ryan kind of a show, right?
Sure. And he could easily host a beautiful dinner party for an intimate crowd of no more than 6 people because it's COVID.
Was that ever a debate?
He could do a lot of things, I'm saying. He could do a lot of great things. He could do a lot of great things.
Especially this is good for him because I saw a clip of Miz and Maurice the other day, Miz and Mrs. whatever, and I was like, yo, the house he has, listen, I know he makes a lot of money, it looked a little bit like, bro, you know, you're setting your sights real high. Like, he knew he was winning the title this year. You know when someone has $11 million, but they buy a house for $12 million?
You're saying you felt this coming?
I think he believes in himself. I respect it. I think he was like, I'm going to be able to afford all this shit. Am I wrong?
Successful cash.
Did he buy a new house, or is that the house he's always lived in?
It's I don't know. It's the house that he's in on this season of. I keep wanting to call it Miz and Morrison.
did he? But I think he did move recently, right? Because didn't he switch
did.
Cities?
Yeah, because he moved to Austin and then he came back to L.A.
Right.
He has a house. I'm telling you, this house looks like a fucking like it's the Richie Rich house. All right. Anyway, so good for Miz. Yeah. Look. I do think Miz beat the title. I believe that Miz winning the title has something to do with this whole Peacock thing. I think they see him as a more mainstream star, and they're going to try to be throwing him and making him like a face of something.
Go across now, the board, you know? Like, look at the champions.
Does it bother you?
Roman and Sasha. Makes sense.
Yeah, but does it bother you how he got the briefcase? Because I realized why his cash in was... You love it? See, I realized why his cash-in felt a little different than the other cash-ins is because this briefcase was a little tainted for me. He not only did he not win it in the Money in the Bank ladder match, which he won it legally off of Otis, who Vince clearly just lost interest in entirely. And then Miz cashed in a way where it was like, all right, he clearly cashed in. And then on a random SmackDown kind of got it back, right?
Yeah.
So it was a little jank for me. And then they haven't built up Miz in any kind of way for me to feel like this cash-in was like, I'm going to do it. Like, I didn't have that same edge anticipation for it, you know?
It's definitely
he also
weird.
Lost the case, too. Remember?
Right.
He, like,
right.
Failed cash-in, but they swindled it into
Morrison. So let's go. Let's recount all the Miz and misses of all this whole briefcase run. Because also, the other thing that's going on, why this feels a little bit, not out of nowhere, but like a little bit janky, as much as we're all happy about it, is that Miz has also been looking fucking wizzique, bro. He's been looking weak for months. Like he's in kerfuffles with Bad Bunny. Like he's not doing anything cool.
Yeah.
He's just getting douched up and down this platform. And then he's just like, yeah, but I got a briefcase. It's live. So whatever. But let's go to the full thing. So him and Otis wins Money in the Bank, which was, I guess, a feel good moment. But I was like, there's no way with this guy. There's no fucking way. And how did Miz get it? They were in a legal... He sued him for the briefcase?
Can you take a second? Pause for a second. There's no way with this guy. What did you mean by that?
With you Otis? Mean,
like, he's not going to successfully cash in at all.
Yeah, there's no way they're putting the fucking
You knew they were going to take it off of him and give it to
I knew
wrestler.
That I thought it was a higher probability that someone better looking is going to take that belt, that case away from him than have him win a world heavyweight title. I thought that maybe he'd cash in and lose and it'd be part of a different. He wasn't main event. He wasn't a guy that, hey, this briefcase is going to elevate some guy who's almost there. This was like, this guy's a flash in the pan this year. Let's just have a good time, guys. It wasn't, he's not ready. Maybe he will be one day. I love him and Gable together, but come on, bro. It wasn't going to happen.
I think that when Otis won, I thought maybe there's a chance they'll finally do it where he cashes in on the IC title or someone picks a bone with him and he goes down to NXT, something like that, just to like take it out of the main title picture, since you have these like fixtures in Drew and Roman that probably weren't going anywhere. Right. And then when they did give it to Miz, I'm like, well, now it's not a question of if, because Miz isn't someone you do that to. So I do agree. It feels like a bit of a B+, because you're like, it's cool that the briefcase is live and that anything could happen and he could just literally jump up from mid card to, you know, top of the card, but it doesn't feel as rewarding because it doesn't feel so earned. So I also understand that. Now going back into kayfabe from the peacock land of like, you know, he'll be great on talk shows and stuff. Yeah. You know, everyone always likes to make those points, but like, I think also another reason why I'm like, can't complain, but a little bit confused and a little bit kind of that's that B+ feeling in me. Like, well, also I love when he's at the top of the card. He's one of the best mouthpieces in the company. So I am excited. I'm just kind of like, what does it all mean? What is like the booking going to be now? He's probably going to have the title going into Mania, right? I mean, unless if Goldberg takes it off him at Fastlane, but like,
always an option.
But I'm interested.
Excuse me, is this Fastlane? I have a title to. I have a title to destroy. I have a title to turn into a prop. Right? Is there a title I can turn into a prop here at Fastlane?
Yeah. So I just wondered, like, you know, is it a multi-man match? Where does Bobby Lashley fit into it? Maybe I missed some stuff on all the Raws. By the way, I would like to say that the entire pay-per-view was about 2.5 hours.
Felt so short.
It is in between the length of a SmackDown and a Raw. or a nice long movie. But
what a great way to think about time.
Yeah,
time, like, you know, like for a while people were like, time is a flat circle.
About like six episodes of a show time, you want to binge.
Time is a SmackDown or a Raw or a median between
the four or five episodes of Dave. But yeah, I don't know. I mean, like, has there been any Bobby Lashley cahoots with the Miz? Like, why did he let him do that? Do you think Bobby Lashley's going to be pissed? Hey, you took my moment. I was going here to challenge the title. Now it's a triple threat.
Tullo, no, as the only guy here who's not fast forwarding the middle of Raw, is there any cahoots of
so
Lashley
right
Miz?
Before during like a segment they had MVP and Miz backstage, and they were talking.
But that was during this pay per view,
right? Yeah. So
I think that's the only seed they planted, right?
That's the only seed they planted, which is, and then in my brain I'm like, well then you should have had Bobby Lashley keep the U.S. title. And then did something like Miz was in the Hurt Business and they have all the gold.
Like, I agree with that. But sorry, Dan, what were you going to say?
No, well, I'm saying is that I think what they were going for was that Lashley was real broken up about losing that title because he didn't even eat that pin, right?
He didn't eat that pin.
And then he's like, yo, fuck it. I'm just going. That other thing happened earlier tonight. I'm going to do it.
So I got what you're saying. You guys are all seemingly in the ether, or like the stars are aligning for a triple threat. Drew, Lashley elevating to main event, and Miz. And you're saying Lashley went in as sort of an agent of chaos of like, fuck that. I can't believe I lost my mid-card belt. Now I'm going up to the top spot.
I mean, I think Miz will be involved. I think Lashley will be involved in Fastlane. I just don't know if it'll carry over into Mania, you know?
Here's what I think is going on, right? So what I think is And because you know I'm the biggest Adam Pearce mark in the whole Cal universe, right? I mean, if you remember your Adam Pearceology,
I'm willing to give you that crown.
And by the way, Dan, I think you're also up there with me. You're a top five guy. Like, you love him. So I respect
anyone who's willing to just play straight, man. Like, we need it. Well, so when he's out there, he's not trying to steal any thunder. He's out trying to ground the show and elevate everybody. And that's what I love.
That's the thing. Yeah, we love a guy who's just going to try to make it make sense. And I think he's so – it's not a glamorous role he's in, but he is so crucial. But anyway – earlier in the quar, Adam Pearce was approached by MVP, and he's like, look, you guys have a problem with retribution. We're going to handle that problem for you guys. And, and he's like, that's great. And he goes like, yeah, but it's going to cost you money. He's like, what are you talking about? It's like, we're the Hurt Business. This is a business.
Right.
So I believe that
Miz hired him.
I think Miz talked to MVP. They came up with a thing like, look, this is a business, man. So you want to give us some money? You want to give us some of that Miz shine? You want to take us on the adventure? Take us out? We'll be your fucking muscle. And we'll be your guy. So I think this is Miz now stabling up with them as there's a for-hire thing. A lot of beef out there. It could sort of go south. Obviously, there's a long time until Mania. At some point, they could, you know, sour in each other's mouths, as it were. But what I think we're gearing up for, guys.
That was filthy.
Because Miz is so great. And Drew McIntyre, look, let's be honest. He is the guy, okay? He beat Lesnar. He is the deserving champ, and he had a WrestleMania moment last year. It wasn't really the same because there was no crowd, and I think WWE feels like they owe him like a packed house, regain that title, overcome the odds, and be the champ that we all love, the big face. So I think stacking the deck against him with a heel Miz and a full stable of strapping young lads and a lot of beef in Lashley and the rest of the guys MVP.
In suits. Guys already in suits.
But between Shelton, like, there's a lot of muscle that's going to make Drew winning that match, walking into Mania and becoming champion, a big thing to overcome. And he's going to do it clean. And he's going to have that, wow, I overcame the odds and became champ moment.
Okay, but can we take a step back for one second? I that all makes sense. But is it best for business? Like, so
I think I think it's good for business.
Is Miz walking into, you're saying a match? Like, right now, what I'm seeing is I'm seeing no Brock Lesnar. So what I am seeing is I'm seeing Miz, Lashley, Drew, triple threat. Is that something we would be excited for?
You're saying that for Mania.
Yeah. That's what I'm seeing.
I'm saying that's very much on the table.
You're saying that, yo, they're full on like for hire. You paid us. That's all good. I don't think so. I really think Vince is like, let me see if I can get Lashley into the main. Like, you know, he's
good.
I think he's could like, I want to push this guy. You know, like, you know, I think they're
equally possible. I don't think Vince is like, let me see if I can push this guy. Vince has had this guy in his fucking toy chest for 20 years. You know, it's not like he's like, let me see if I can find a spot for him. I think we know what Lashley's capable of. It ain't much, okay? He's
He's if you Trump
put
supporter.
If you put.
Lashley's a confirmed Trump supporter, right?
Is he really?
Well, he helped him save Vince's hair.
Oh. I mean, yeah, I guess so. All right. I'm just saying, like, I wouldn't put it past the guy. Look, because he's a Air Force guy. It doesn't matter. The point is, he might be. Lashley is a guy who has so much of a few things, right? So much physicality, so much look, so much moves. Like,
he has little eyebrow.
So no eyebrows. Those are microplanes. Those are
many sisters.
So many sisters. But he's very.
I love you.
He's such a charisma suck.
Sarah, I love you.
No, it's a funnier name than that. But it was like, what was the name? I don't know. We should look that up. But it's great. But you put him with a guy like MVP, who's a real good wrestling brain, like a real good mic man. Like, he knows what's up. Then all of a sudden, Lashley rules, kind of. I just don't think Lashley's main event Mania potential. Like, I don't think Vince is looking at him and being like, I need him in the picture, other than for the beat.
So you're saying Miz is a match for Mania?
Miz is a big, 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 big fucking star. And Drew is one of the biggest pro wrestling stars they have. Like, you could put a match on Drew's back and not feel bad about it. And then you got Orton and Bray are going to get to whatever the fuck they get into. And that's locked in for those two guys. So it's all just who else is left at the top of the Raw card anyway? AJ? I mean, who gives a shit? He'll figure it out.
Yeah,
he needs a match, man.
He does. But I'm saying, I don't think I think that I feel confident saying I bet Drew and Miz are big enough to carry that main event. I don't think we need Lashley in there, but I could see it going triple threat land. It's hard for me to believe that Vince or any of us are going to really feel like we need Lashley in the main event of Mania triple threat.
I can't imagine that.
I can't imagine it. What I can imagine is Drew overcomes this fucking, you know, conglomerate of beef where he's got to beat Miz and the Hurt Business and who the fuck else knows what's stacked against him. And that'll be like a real, you know, statement made, a real crowning achievement, regaining that strap on the grandest stage of them all in front of 20,000 sick people who have raging cases of COVID. that just seems like it'd be a great moment that they want to create for him. That's all I'm saying.
It's COVID at the Cove. Is Tampa Bay a Cove?
I love it.
But what do you guys like? What do you really think that the Miz and the Hurt Business are going to be an actual cahoot outside of this one-time deal? Also, throwing this out there just for no reason.
I think they're just going to ignore it, right?
Yeah.
I think they're in cahoots, but go on.
McMahon's razor says otherwise. But I think
poor, right?
Okay. Now I actually can wrap my head around Miz and Drew just one-on-one. And I would actually like to talk more about that because I think you need to really make Miz like a batter heel. There needs to be a little bit more there to like contend with the power and the presence that is Drew McIntyre right now, how tested he is from this year.
That's what's crazy about Miz winning the cash-in game is like Drew, even in this cash-in, okay, he won the chamber. Lashley had to smash his head 40 times against the Spanish announce table. Then Miz had to come in, and he still ate that, not a finisher, a signature move. So after coming out of the chamber, like, Drew is looking about as strong as you can look. I mean, he just
We're talking about Drew McIntyre beat Brock Lesnar clean. He is a perfect 10 strength level in WWE universe. Like, he's right. The strongest possible wrestler you can be, period. I mean, that's what we're dealing with. That's why you have Miz, Morrison, Lashley, Benjamin, yeah. MVP, Cedric, throw Retribution in there. They're going to throw the whole kitchen sink at this fucking guy.
You need to get that Miz from 3 years ago back.
Unless you go the lame route, I guess. And we're not the lame route, but like instead of a triple threat, would they ever do a fatal four way and throw AJ in there? And then you have AJ, Bobby, Miz, Drew.
Keep in mind, can we take a step back from Mania for a second and remember that it's two nights? So you're gonna have probably one night that's Sasha, Bianca as the main or something, or Charlotte.
I'll tell you what.
Something. And then the other night is clearly the last match of both nights is Edge Roman, right?
I'll tell you what.
You
know what this is? This is Raw and SmackDown being two shows that clearly this chamber, it was a perfect parallel to each show. SmackDown nailed it. Raw lost.
Yeah, but the cash-in was cool. No, we didn't.
No, like, no. What I'm saying is that
the cash-in was cool. And SmackDown was actually very straightforward booking to me.
But you had Edge come out and challenge.
You had two different ends to two different pay-per-views.
So the storyline is going. With Raw, it's like, oh, we're with Miz. How do we get to WrestleMania now with Miz?
Also fun though. Like that's also
that's what I'm saying. Which is so interesting. The two shows are so different in the way where they booked this Elimination Chamber, where it was like, oh, you have Reigns, right? You have and you know he was gonna win, you know he was gonna come out.
SmackDown was way cleaner. The booking was way cleaner and
right,
more sensible.
That's what I'm saying.
And the Raw was a little chaotic, which is
right. More, and that's how the fucking two shows are, though. That's really like legit how they are, and that's how it's gonna be. So it's like it's interesting to see what's gonna happen with Raw now and how they build to WrestleMania with Miz as champ. And it's
how much time till Mania? What where are we at? I don't right know. Here. I can't believe like that it's a year after.
Yeah, we're 6 weeks out, basically.
Can you believe that like the last Mania we watched together on like fucking Zoom and that's what's happening again already? Like it's insane.
That's how I gauge my like timeline by Manias. So it's
so really, do I. It is like the restart. Too. It is like the reset of my New Year's Eve is like Mania, I feel like, right? Like
dude, it's also gonna be crazy to think like that COVID has been going on so long that we will have not been all together at WrestleMania for two years in a row. That's a lot of time.
I know. It's crazy. The time felt like COVID started right at Mania. So
yeah,
it's
it
like two
timing.
Manias is 1 year.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
So it's like, right. So it feels like insane when you think of it in terms of Mania. It makes it really fucking sad.
Well, also the 3 million dead bodies make it pretty sad too. I already knew it was sad, but this really hits home for me. The two Manias.
I didn't even know it was sad until I missed the second Mania. I didn't even, to be honest. Yeah. I was kind of like, this thing's not even a big deal. I had COVID and I have to go get a chest x-ray tomorrow still from my COVID. But, wait, so Mania is in, that's one, about 5-6 weeks. Yeah. Wow.
To go to Tampa. I'd rather go to Dallas, and then Dallas, LA back to back are going to be sick.
Yeah.
We're
going to
be
right.
So fucking sick.
Yeah. I'll see you.
Only year apart. But it's going to be fun. I've been to, those will be, well, I live in LA, but yeah, I think those two times. Yeah. So anyway, look. Miz, I'm excited to see where they go with it, but it is interesting because it's hard to see the match. It's like hard to see, like, they've not built Miz to be a main eventer in any way.
The skull crushing finale didn't look good.
Listen to me when I say this.
That's a finish. Like,
Bad Bunny
up
either.
To him. He had to like get up, and then he got his leg.
Don't rule out Bad Bunny, man. I mean, I'm telling you, you think I'm crazy?
You think Bad Bunny? Wait, what?
What are you saying right now, bro?
Do not rule out Bad Bunny going after
I
the
do
Miz.
Think you're, I do not
going after the Miz. Okay, all right,
Do not rule out Tori Wilson.
Okay,
that's what
I'm saying. Can we not even entertain this notion? Just talk like to fucking normal.
Tori.
No, I want to talk to Skylar's point about. That the skull.
You don't honestly think Bad Bunny could get involved?
Dude, Tullo, shut the fuck up already. I'm not talking about Bad Bunny.
Why are you yelling at me like that?
What is
like, Tullo
saying?
How is that not a realistic thing? How is that not
you
a realistic
think
thing?
Bad Bunny's going to win the title, the heavyweight championship? Is that what you're saying?
He could definitely do something on the way to WrestleMania to fuck around with this. Have you not? Did David Arquette not win the fucking heavyweight title once?
All right. Yeah. I'm sorry for yelling. I just think that
you
I'd rather
don't
talk.
Think that Bad Bunny's gonna get involved with the heavyweight title.
I think getting involved is one thing. I think it sounded like you were saying he might be involved in a title run or a title shot, and those I think are preposterous ideas. I think could he interfere in this match?
Same thing about Ronda Rousey. That's it.
Yeah. Excuse
very
me.
Different. That's very different. She's a supreme athlete.
Just when saying, the fuck did I ever say that Ronda Rousey?
I
think
said
a minute,
people. Did it say you? I said people.
Yeah,
people
but guess
said,
who I am?
People
I'm
said
not
that
people.
Match was going to suck. Best match.
No, I didn't. I don't give a fuck what anyone says except for me. And I said Ronda Rousey's amazing since day one.
Ronda Rousey is one of my
take
guys.
Take it easy, man.
Obviously.
We got to move on for time. I want to talk about this Miz on Drew thing. Skull Crusher finale situation. He needs
I
a step
hear,
stool.
No,
he needs
I
a step stool.
I want to hear more about. I'm sorry, Shebs. I want to hear more about Tullo's Bad Bunny.
No.
I want to know what he means.
So all right. All right, Tullo, the host
Tullo,
of the podcast
don't,
has spoken.
All right, so I'm not going to write off Bad Bunny like Shebs is doing, even though I'm inclined to 100% agree with him. But let me hear you out. And Skylar, you want to hear out Tullo about his Bad Bunny booking?
I feel like I don't have a choice, and I'm here for it.
Yeah.
Hey, can I ask Skylar a question? Skylar, do you rule out Tullo's booking, but you want to hear it anyway, or do you actually
100% rule it out and 100% okay. Now at this point definitely want to hear it at this point.
Okay, let's perfect. Just check. Just want to check.
The only real wrestler that Bad Bunny has had beef with was The Miz. I mean, The Miz destroyed his DJ equipment. They did a thing in the segment. They came out. He jumped. I mean, if they want to do something crazy at WrestleMania, it's there. They can
maybe a spot. Maybe a spot, man. But like
we're
talking about
you,
the
don't
about
rule
the,
it out. Don't
now Tullo, can we talk about
out.
Your predictions? Can
we're talking about predictions? The WWE title at WrestleMania, guys. Okay. You think this would be a DJ equipment spot in that match? Like, what are we talking about?
Yo, Tullo, your booking tonight was Randy Orton would win the chamber.
Okay, and Miz won. So you didn't think you
got eliminated first.
And the Miz won, so it's
and then you
the
said
Miz
you said
champion.
Definitely Edge would wrestle McIntyre, right?
You did say that. You were pretty adamant
that didn't
about
happen.
That
didn't happen.
You were pretty adamant. Fine. Actually, the last time we all got together and did one of these, I think we could go across the board and say that the three of us were probably pretty on the money, and you were in fucking La La Land with Ryan Gosling over there. I don't know what's going on.
I fucking movie. Pray. Love I hope play. The Tullo. I hope. This is cut to us. It's the day after WrestleMania. It's at Raw. We're recording our post show.
And that buddy's the champ.
I'm possibly making Roman Reigns one of my guys. We'll see at that moment. And Tullo's like, I fucking told you Bad Bunny would win the chat title. You all be funny coming.
And then he holds up like that WrestleMania moment. He holds the 24/7 in one hand and the WWE title in the other. And it's like fireworks everywhere. Pyro as he holds the two belts.
And then
in the
Monday
air.
After Mania, the Raw after Mania, guess who's fucking music hits? It's Goldberg. Goldberg's music hits. He comes out, challenges Bad Bunny, spears him, and Goldberg's the champ.
Goldberg's going after Bad Bunny. I would kill to see Goldberg do a classic streak style squash on Bad Bunny. Oh my god, excuse me. Oh, Bad Bunny. I'm here to wrestle something called Bad Bunny. All right, anyway. All right, Tullo, thanks for being here, man. All right. Anyway, back to the podcast. So, look, they'll have to build up Miz. If anyone can do it, Miz can, because, I mean, not to bring Tullo back up, but Tullo said that I put the promo on a pedestal tonight. But there's no such thing as doing that. And Miz on the microphone will sell you that he belongs in the main event of WrestleMania. If anyone can do that, it's him. You know, he has... Look, when he, like, 2 weeks ago, or maybe even this week, when he's yelling into the lens, he's so fucking good. Mm-hmm. I mean, none of these guys can do it. They can't
He's incredible. He's one of the best mic guys in the history of the business, for real. He just is. He's, without a doubt, one of the best mic guys working today. All I'm saying is, though... The past, like, all of 2021 so far, and probably even a little bit before, he was just getting really douched out. Like, he wasn't looking like a guy on track to become champ. I mean, he got the briefcase, but even then, he got it.
It's irrelevant to WWE, though.
I know, I'm saying. But he got that thing, I believe, in a kangaroo court run by JBL. Like, it's not like it's been ridiculous.
And it was a lunchbox Money in the Bank briefcase.
He's been carrying around a bunch of deli meat.
Salami, yeah.
He was carrying around a bunch of fucking salami in that thing for months. And now it's like all of a sudden he's the fucking champion. Like, it's just going to take a couple weeks for that to sink in and for us to, like, start believing him again.
Because they goofed him out the whole year. Like, you can lose in wrestling. You can – in WWE, we're trained to be like Kofi. Like, you probably have a super losing record, and all of a sudden we'll agree. Like, you're on a streak. You've hit a streak for no reason. You know what I mean? Like, we're fine with that.
Right.
We're probably fine with that. But they put Miz in a really interesting zone, which is, like, the lunchbox zone, where, like, he was completely goofed. He was doing Christmas segments, New Year's. His goof segments, like him and Miz would, like, mess up the script and do, like, a Two Stooges routine, right?
It was complete. This guy was in the straight, but it was always, I guess,
the Rumble. He got douched out to Crumholtz and Drew McIntyre. he had Bad Bunny his Royal Rumble appearance. The most important match of the year was getting beat up by Bad Bunny, which carried over into Raw. You know what I mean?
Future WWE champion, Bad Bunny.
So, again, it all goes to show you that, like, in wrestling, you could get hot just like that, right? Like, all Kofi Kingston had to do was go from being, like, a third-string backup replacement into that chamber and have a great match to get the crowd on his side, and then it organically happened, right? But that is not what's happening here. Miz didn't get hot, and now he's riding it to Mania. They were like, Miz, now you go get hot. We're going to make you the champion, and you'll just make it hot. Like, there was no natural heat-up for Miz. It was just like, we trust – which, by the way, is almost more impressive that they trust him enough that they could give him that and say, look, you'll be able to make this red hot, and we know you can. That's fucking awesome. I'm just saying that's why it feels a little strange now.
If anyone could reverse engineer it, it's Miz. And he's going to with a promo tomorrow and then more and then just like good stuff. And by the time Mania rolls around, we're going to be far past this conversation and be like, oh, yeah, Miz is a champ. Like, we just know that.
And I think he's going to look strong. I mean, he's a great chicken shit heel, obviously, but I think he'll look pretty strong. I think they'll have him do some badass stuff on the way, but I do believe there will be he'll have a pack of dudes. I think he's gonna have the Hurt Business in the corner, at least for
Other thing about the Miz is, if you remember, like, I fucking love the Miz. You can remember back, if you guys, because now everyone's dipping back in the archives of this pod and using it against me. Go back and dip. Remember when I went to a party and they asked you who's your favorite wrestler right now, and I said the Miz at the party.
The Miz is actually the definition of one of my guys.
Yeah, he's fucking amazing. So I love to see it. But I just also was like, felt like what was so interesting is like Drew is, to me, is just like killing it. I think he's like, he's just as the epitome of a champion. It's like the fucking sword, the skirt, perfect kilt, perfect shape. He's got fire. He walks to the ring. It's fire. He looks like going into war. And then he goes into this chamber. Everyone was knocking on his on his plexiglass, and he's so fucking tough. He had lines where he was like, to the cameraman, he's like, I told you to move. Like, you know, he had some awesome moments if you saw that. And then you're like, man, this guy's firing on all cylinders. And then Miz, who's been firing on really no cylinders, comes in and wins. And so you're like, wow, like, but that's the beauty of wrestling, right? Mm-hmm. It's fucking fun. That's fun.
It definitely like makes me excited to watch Raw for the next 2 weeks to see what the aftermath.
That was going to be my point. I was going to say, all of a sudden, for the first time, I'm like, wow, I actually have to tune into Raw to see what the Miz is going to do.
I just was so ready for Drew Brock again, but like, I also don't need it, right? I don't need it, you know? So I was just positive that's what we would see.
Brock can still show up on Monday too. Never count out Brock.
What if they like Drew, Brock, Miz, Triple Threat?
Imagine Brock just comes out. Miz is like, I'm the champ. He thinks everything's going to be good. And Brock's music hits. And he's like, oh, fuck. What did I get myself into?
I mean, the Brock conundrum here is, what's up with Heyman? Because of Brock with no Heyman, Brock doesn't need him at this point. Brock could just be Brock. Yeah. But I'm curious, like, that's why I don't really think we're seeing Brock this year.
We're not.
I don't think we're seeing him. Like,
and that's okay. It's okay.
I'd be so into that version of Brock where he doesn't have anybody like kind of with the leash on him, you know?
Dude, you know what, Brock, you guys should all be clamoring to see? You guys should all be clamoring for Brock cuts his own promos off script, like after he beat Frank Mir at UFC 100. That
golden horseshoe
Brock,
up your ass?
He had a horseshoe up his ass. I pulled it out and beat him over the head with it.
And the one after Cormier won the title, and he came into the fucking octagon. He's like, this whole fucking division sucks.
I mean, it's incredible.
So, Skylar,
yeah,
Edge made his decision tonight to obviously wrestle Roman Reigns.
Clearly.
on this day, he saw clearly that it was time for him to wrestle Reigns. Are you excited for Edge Reigns at WrestleMania?
I am. I've been thinking this for a few weeks that, you know, Edge's return at Rumble was great. It clearly wasn't what last year's was, because how could it be? But it was definitely good to see him. Also, it was spoiled by him telling it on the go-home show. Remember, he declared his entrance, which was
hard. I think they did that since they didn't want anyone to feel the pressure of his entering from last year. Like, I didn't think they you know what I mean? They didn't want it to feel like... That's why I think they did it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I get it. And so whatever, I'm past that. But I think that like he's just clicking. It's there's something about the fact that like his hair is looking a little bit less frizzy, and that he's tying it tight into a bun. Mm-hmm. He looks tight. He looks focused. Mm-hmm. He looks less like he's doing the eyes and then the acting's following. It's all clicking. And I've been thinking this
what
way.
What a pro note. Love it. A pro observation.
And I've been thinking this way for a couple weeks, actually. Just the way in which he's been holding himself, I could feel him getting, like, locking in. I mean, lock it in. And tonight was definitely the moment for me. The way in which he pointed to this sign, it's fucking on. No more wishy-washy. No more who am I going to pick. I'm going to put over the NXT guys. I'm the old vet. Oh, hey, Punishment Martinez, here's a handshake. It's like, I'm the main event of WrestleMania. I'm going against Roman, and I am now, as a fan, completely on board, and I'm very interested to see.
And he nailed that spear, man, which is mattered.
Let me tell you something.
He clocked him with that spear.
That was the best spear of Edge's career. That's a career spear.
A career spear?
That was perfect. It was a perfect spear. Because I want
to go to WrestleMania.
I mean, Dan, you know I've been critical of Edge's spears, and I love Edge, but I've always been critical of his spear because
he always falls to his knees on the side.
He kind of falls to his knees on the side, like where the big guys just like launch and just dive like a football tackle. Yeah, he's like kind of like, oh, yeah, me too, guys. And plus, I mean, getting speared by a guy like Goldberg or Roman, who are like their shoulders are so big they look like painful to even touch.
But
like
Edge just doesn't have the kind of.
Both football players.
But I said Edge actually looks like a spear.
Yeah, but that doesn't make it
a guy built like a spear. That's what I'm saying. Yeah, but
being built like a spear doesn't make you more dangerous to give a spear. I'm just saying it always looks
the other guy should be called a football tackle. He's the guy that should be actually called a spear.
Ed just hit him with the harpoon. He just hit him with a harpoon.
The Nova Scotia. He hit him. He got like right like a salmon. Like
Canadian spear.
Yeah, like a beautiful, beautiful Calgary salmon. And
Edge is spearing for fish.
Yeah. Does anyone think it's weird that his finisher used to be the impaler and now it's a spear? Those are both synonyms. Like a spear is an impaler in a way.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So he loves puncturing people with sticks.
And also he likes to puncture, like he was rated R, so he likes to puncture you as well, right?
Sure
the guy like Edge is always trying to be inside you. That's all.
Boy. Okay.
I love you.
You think you know somebody.
Inside of you.
Yo, that's so funny. You say it to Edge. Edge. Oh, you think you know somebody. That'd be Edge's Snicker commercial. I mean.
But the
WrestleMania is the Snickers is the sponsor for WrestleMania. So
yeah. Well, that's
you think you know Mania. Me, but I'm actually.
It was a spear of his career. It looked amazing. I loved everything about it. And wow, like how locked in can you be? Like Skylar said, like it just feels right. Like in all the ways that the Miz thing, which we all love, just felt like, okay, whoa. This takes a second to just sort of like recalibrate. The Edge thing just is like, this is exactly what needs to happen. This is right where it needs to be. It all feels good. The question is, what's the outcome? We don't need to talk about right now. Like I know that Edge has one more run in him. Like, he's going to be the top guy, like, have the top belt at least one more time in his career, if for no other reason than a wrestling purist like Adam Copeland.
You sound like Ric Flair right now.
A man at his farewell who cried because he had to retire from this business. A guy like Adam Copeland, like Edge, needs to have that belt, and he needs to drop it. He needs to do the honors. He needs to go out on his back because he never was able to do that. Vince was never going to let them put that belt on Alberto Del Rio's debut fucking Mania when Edge had to retire. And Edge, a purist like him, wants to lose.
I think it was the opening match of that night on that pay-per-view also, if I believe it. It was in daylight. It didn't feel right.
When would he drop that title, though?
I know what's happened. Here's what I think might happen. This is like the safest, easy booking. But like Edge wins. Roman goes to Raw. Edge has a run against Rollins at SummerSlam. We get to see him locked up with AJ.
Which would be great.
Yeah, and then he will put over who the next person who should be champion.
Well, I think you'll see Edge Roman too, and Edge will probably take the Roman all next Roman year.
Maybe that's what it is. We get a year of Edge.
But we all agree, like, Edge should just win. It's like, it's Edge should win, man. But
right. Now, I don't know if he's
Edge
gonna.
Is that you know his Mania entrance is going to rule. Like, you can't say that about a lot of wrestlers, really. And that's what people shit on Goldberg all the time. And then you're like, but, like, when he enters, it's fucking cool. You know, Edge comes out and you know he's going to do his you know it's – the smoke goes up. He runs out. Like, you know, you're going to be so pumped to see it. You know?
Edge is a guy that we've been watching this whole time, like, since the Attitude Era, right? I mean, and he wasn't always there.
Right,
like
we knew him, but we didn't.
We thought we knew him, and he warned us. He was like, yo, you think you know me. You think I'm just sort of like a jobber. I'm in the Brood, whatever. I got long, silly. And then he got the dumb pants. But look, the matches were always good, right? Yeah. Those triple threat TLC matches are the stuff of legend, obviously. Yeah. But he kept getting better and better at all the things, not just the in-ring, not just the promo, not just the look, not just the gimmick. He was getting better at everything this whole time. And when he retired, when he had to retire, he was at his fucking prime, at his peak. That's why it hurt so bad, because he was crushing it. And we have him back now, and he's as good as ever. He's been in the best. Now he's in the best shape of his life, which is great to see. And look, man, like there's certain guys. Not everyone has this. There's another factor we don't really talk about. It's the chill factor. Okay. Some guys can give me chills. And some guys will never give me chills in their fucking life. Keith Lee, I don't give a fuck if I'm in a deep sea freezer. Look, but you know what? All of you guys, every single guy in this episode, if you're in a fucking freezer at zero Kelvin, is Keith Lee ever capable of giving you the chills?
I like
zero
this.
Kelvin.
I like this.
What?
Why did
I like
to be
his role entrance against
ready in a freezer?
But did you get chills? I literally, when Edge
okay,
came back,
can we take a step
I got.
Back?
I got goosebumps. It was
Yo,
one of the Shebs. Best things I've seen in wrestling.
I agree. I know what your point is, okay? The point
Edge
is
Edge has chill
is that,
factor. He's got he's the got, chill factor.
Listen, there's something about some of these guys just really have something. Like, Orton has it every time. Like, Orton was getting in that chamber tonight, and he just got up on that fucking turnbuckle.
That drizzle pyro.
And you're like,
oh,
you're
my
like,
God.
Put his dick right. He put his dick right in Sheamus' face.
Yeah. Right in Sheamus' face.
But you know, like, you have those moments where you're like some guys, they do something like that, and you're like, oh, this is why I love wrestling. Like, this, right, you have the, and Orton does it for me more than any other wrestler, probably.
Currently,
yeah. Orton's got the chill. Orton gives me the chills more than any wrestler, and he gives me the hot flashes more than any wrestler. I need to cool off sometimes. He's going to get me steaming.
Cool off. Yeah. And
you're like
and
a lady at the track. You're like,
I got the vapors. Like, I got the vapors.
Yeah. You're at the fucking Porcupine racetrack. Woo. Yeah, but but you're right. Like, a lot of wrestlers don't even. Like nowadays, the younger guys, I think they don't even try. Like, it's like it's kind of a lot of my beef with like NXT is like it feels a lot of like looking cool for the back as opposed to wowing the camera, you know, and just like being bigger than wrestling, being transcending what it is, where you really suspend people's disbelief, like the same way that people see, they don't see Chris Evans, they see Captain America, you know, like how you really feel that or something. It's only, and like Randy does that. Some of these wrestlers can do it. And then some, it's like, he's a great worker, great hand, like whatever the fuck you say about them. Cody does it for me sometimes. Like Cody has moments where I'm like, yo, Cody feels, he makes it feel really important. He really transports me to another dimension of markdom.
How important,
you know,
it is to do a gender reveal on, you know.
All right. But look, honestly, though, to even say Cody does it for me sometimes is I think, an understatement. I mean, that guy's given me some chills moments. The Nick Aldis, like the quest for the NWA belt.
Kenny never does it, though. Can I just give it a point?
I
love
never.
Kenny.
Not
he
never.
Just never
not
does
never.
It for me. I
not
like
never.
Kenny, but that's not his specialty.
Okay. I don't want to talk about Kenny right now because
AJ
Cody
does it.
Something.
AJ does it.
I'm just, AJ can Seth give me this. But you know what? I don't think, who?
Seth can.
Seth can give me chills.
Oh, yeah.
Seth can get me going.
Oh,
I mean,
yeah.
Just thinking
yeah.
about that, and you think about the heist of the century.
Charlotte, sometimes.
Charlotte can give me those chills, baby.
Yeah, yeah.
Absolutely. That entrance, she comes out in that robe just being fucking Charlotte Flair, and you're like, yeah, she's Charlotte Flair. I mean, what do we expect? Of course I have the chills.
Yeah, Dominic Mysterio.
They do that shot, Skylar, nope. What do you call that shot? What is Dominic? Tullo, I don't want to cut off your mic, but you're killing my fucking flow. Cool. Yo, Charlotte, when they get that, Skylar, what do you call that shot where they go, it's like an upshot.
Like a hero shot. It's like a hero shot.
Yeah. It was just said on the last podcast that you had with the guy. It was when you make the person look like huge. No.
What are you talking about? Monster shot? Like, there's monster lighting, but this is, like, it's a hero
no,
shot. I don't know. There might not even be a term for it, to be honest.
What's his name was just on the pod, and he said it. He said the exact shot. They
oh,
did
Robert?
It with Omos the other, they did with Omos the other night, where it was, like, when he was had Xavier
Robert
Woods choke slam, and it was, like, down from below. It was sick. Yeah.
It's a low-angle shot.
Yeah.
Hero shot. You could call it all those things.
Hero
for sure.
Shot.
Yeah.
But when Charlotte does that, and then the pyro goes
the
off
pyro.
At the top, and
yeah.
you're like, wow.
Like, yeah.
You know?
Bailey. Bailey has that too.
All right. Someone.
Bailey just never does that for me.
Bailey has that. Bailey has that same shot. It's the same shot. I don't
yeah,
know
but that, but that's the point. The point is when they use that same shit on Bailey, I don't give a rat's Johnson.
You
when they do it on Charlotte.
Awesome.
When
Triple
they do it on
H would
Charlotte,
have it
I'm
sometimes for me.
Yes.
Triple H, I think, could give other people the chills, but he.
But Triple
only
H
really
has it the way Cody has it. It's like a self-made chill.
Yeah,
maybe.
Oh.
A lot of manufacturing.
It's not even just about pyro. Sometimes, like there was times like Kurt Angle has a pretty basic entrance, but there are times where Kurt Angle come out and just spin in the ring, like early
but,
on,
look,
and you're
guys,
like.
By the way, it's not just for their
honestly,
entrance.
Honestly, I'm like feeling like a little kid right now. This is great.
But it's not just about entrances. I love that. I love that. And we're rolling. But I'm just saying, I just want to make the point. It's not just for people's entrances
right.
that you could get the chills. It's have they ever had a moment where you got the chills watching them perform or even a promo? Like Cena's cut some promos that I was like on the verge of tears for. Like, I mean, I've seen these guys move people. For real, like you
oh,
get
that, when he called out that cancer kid with the sign.
And that oh, so that's I mean that's when I just fell in love with the guy more than ever before. Like that feud when Kevin Owens came up from NXT and won the US title, and then they were going back and forth, and that promo of John Cena's where he's saying and he's basically telling Owens, "Fight Owens, fight," is the same thing as never give up. Like I'm talking to you, buddy. And he's like, I got all these colors. You want to make fun of all the gear, but I don't do it for you. I do for that little boy. People like that little boy right there with a never give up sign. Oh. And they show the
chills,
kid. And
the even the you kid's right crying. Now, chills.
The kid's crying. It says, I beat cancer because thank you, John Cena. Never go. And I'm sitting there bawling my eyes out.
Oh, my God.
I mean, you think Keith fucking Lee is going to get me there?
TikTok.
Let me sit in the center, Jason. Like, that's kind of his.
Yeah. Hey, look, Will, sometimes, you know, people are going to bully you at school, but I'm proud of you for coming to me. He's basically Uncle Phil from Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
But I'm literally.
But anyway, Roman Edge, we get this match. So Edge, I'm hoping Edge going forward is going to be keyed up with the promos, because I wasn't totally feel like I'm kind of not that into this, like, when do I make my decision thing. Like, I think it should be, it's like I like that Edge is like, I'm going after Roman because he has such a clear reason to go after Roman. Like, that is such a great obstacle for a 47-year-old guy coming back to reclaim it. Like, Roman is the guy to beat, you know? I believe Edge will make you vested in this match in a way that I believe we have not been vested in a Mania match in a long time.
And Roman wants it too. Roman wants it. You know, he's made it clear. He's like, I want this fucking match. I want to end you, dude. You think you're going to fucking come in here? No way. Like, that's the vibe that I'm getting from Roman right now, which is so insane to fucking think about when you think about it. Roman Reigns is the guy right now, you know?
You know what? Fuck that. I love Roman.
That's what I'm saying, but it's just so wild to think about how fucking amazing
he is. He was always this close. He was a vest away. He's always... Everyone
he just
always
wants a heel. He's a heel. It's as simple as that. You know,
we've been clamoring for it for fucking 5 years plus. Like, we knew what needed to be done, and we didn't know they were ever going to really give it to us, and they did, and they've just been nailing it. We got to respect it. They've been nailing Roman Reigns.
I don't know that I'd have it any other way, and I feel like even in the Thunderdome, there was a lot of like, well, let's all not forget that we hated Roman. I'm like, you know. We were hating the booking, and like, you know, he was so clearly being pushed. And
well, I always have to re-explain the nuance of what I'm saying. Is that what I just said? I'm not saying Roman is not doing my guy caliber work. I said I'm going to hold off judgment until the Monday after WrestleMania, which is a couple things. One, a fun thing to do.
Yes.
Right? One thing, it's just a fun thing to do. And then two, also, is that I've been burned Roman in a long time. I want to see if he can keep it up.
I have a question. What do you expect is going to happen?
I don't expect. I expect him to become one of my guys the Monday after WrestleMania.
Yeah, we're damn near buying real fireworks for it.
Win, lose, or draw. You expect he'll.
No, I'm hoping he loses. I want Edge to have the title, but I expect. I can't imagine him blowing it. But who knows? The curve. What about the swerve? Suffering succotash promo. It comes out of nowhere on the go home.
That's what I was about to say. I was like, well, I wonder what could actually take away this timeline.
Like, it's the best. Back on?
He puts the vest back on for Mania and turns face.
Oh my God.
If the vest even goes near him, he's not one of my guys.
He comes out from the crowd wearing a vest, and we're like, what is going on?
I may never watch WWE product again if he puts that vest on. I'll literally cry and
he's
scream.
Definitely not. As a matter of fact, I was thinking about this because I was looking at The Rock, obviously, like I do.
Oh my God.
Getting huge because he's doing Black Adam, and he's huge regardless, but he's getting to like this next level.
Yeah, and he's so focused on getting huge.
And he's like working out 1 a.m. You see what he's doing. It's fucking insane. But I'm worried about him. You're worried about him?
Me too.
I'm worried he's going to get too big. Too. And then how do you get smaller after you get that big? I don't know what's going to happen.
It looks so unhealthy. Like,
he just takes a breath in between words and his chest flexes. And it's like,
incredible.
What is going on?
You know, there's no way I don't juice in this lifetime.
Here's the word for what his muscles are.
It's like, whoa.
His muscle fibers are scintillating. They're just like pulsing with twitch. It's incredible.
They're just looking at each other and all the time. That's why they're trying to get close. They're like hopping. Bro. They're like, I want to see the other muscles.
Yeah.
So they're popping above. Yo, but here's we should act out his muscles. That'd be a good sketch, SNL. But folks, sure. but Like I'm saying is that I think Roman is looking at The Rock and he's like, look, I want that career, which he'll never have, by the way, just whatever. But that's not even an insult, right? I mean, like, who? It's an anomaly. But I think we see Roman start. He's going to get even bigger, even mm-hmm. like he's not. He's never going back to the vest. I give him faith that he's not. He's not going back to the vest until obviously he's like, why Booker T wears a vest now when he's like 50 right. something, you know?
Yeah, all right. So how can I get you interested in this? What if he trades you, vest goes back on, but pants right. go off, he turns into panties. So he's wearing a bikini bottom with a vest.
I'll still be one of my guys for that.
Yeah, okay. Absolutely. Okay.
Absolutely. Okay. Vest with panties? I'm into that.
Not bad.
I don't think I've ever seen, have we ever seen that look?
I feel like Gargano wears it as entrance attire, but I don't know.
Yes,
really
yes, yes.
Totally. By the way, little mini tangent, but yeah. Do you think we ever see a Shield reunion in WWE?
Yes. Once, but I think AEW so. At some point, like 2 years, AEW will go bankrupt. Like, unfortunately, well, look, I don't want that. I'm just saying, wrestling companies, we've just seen it over time and time again. A second one is not sustainable. Like a second huge one, and then WWE will buy all the other guys up. I mean, what's their model right now? Their model's to be on TNT. It's like a dying channel. Like where you know, like
TNT is. TNT is drama. I don't think they're dying. I think they're doing okay.
Oh, that's true. Drama's not dying. Skylar's drama dying?
I was only on TV. I was only on a TBS show. I can't tell you, which is very funny. Very funny.
Very, very funny.
But,
characters not welcome, though, right? That's
yeah, it's so hard to make content when you don't allow characters to be a part of it, but that's just
yeah, I thought that was odd. But yeah, no, listen, I don't know. I hope I'm wrong. I'm a man. I took WCW for granted. I'm loving AEW. If AEW they announce like we're shutting down, I will probably actually cry. Like I'm like it's such a great thing. But it's like I think Vince wins this battle like he always does.
No, of course he's gonna win. And that's the thing about wrestling.
And then they'll be back. Mox will be back.
You can never say never. Never is forever, right? Until one of them dies, it's not never because Bret Hart came back. You know, like it's never. You know, there's always a chance.
So yeah, I think the Shield. There's just too much money in
5 years
again. Yeah,
I'm just trying to think of like in the rational, like thinking of WCW when it existed. But were there wrestlers that left WWE and became bigger superstars in WCW, like the way Ambrose has become Moxley?
Yes.
Yeah, NWO.
Yeah, I mean,
yeah. But like, Kevin Nash, are all those guys? Sure became... You think? Are we saying that Nash and Hall are bigger than?
Diesel and Razor Ramon, yeah, like, probably, you know, yeah,
right.
Probably.
You know, I'm just interested to see, like, look at Moxley and where he's at and what he's done and where he's going. You know, like, is it the same kind of? Yeah, but you're that?
He's not doing it next year, too.
He was a bigger star on WWE TV.
Yeah, but also
the reality.
But to say ever, like, look, there's guys like Raven, like people. We're going back and forth between those companies and we're garbage at WWF and then went back and forth. Yeah. Like it happens. I don't know. I can't, it's not like, hey, it was Goldberg, you know, had hair and was called like William Gold and had like an accountant gimmick in WWE and then became Goldberg
and also,
over there.
Talking about WCW is weird because it actually kind of went the opposite way because the whole problem with WCW is that like the old guys ran, they booked the ship. So it was like Hogan Flair putting themselves over. And so guys like Jericho came over and became huge stars. Like all the younger guys came over and became huge stars because there was no room for them in WCW.
Kind of the opposite because you have like, you know, Vince doing everything who's like the old guy with his own, you know, taste.
Yeah, they took Benoit, they took Eddie, they took all those guys and made them huge. Yeah. Well, anyway, we'll see what happens. But yeah, I do think we see that. We didn't see much from the women's division didn't move forward tonight, right?
At all. Tag team match.
Well, they had a tag match, which who cares? And then Asuka's TBD match. It turns out it was against some nachos and cheese in the back at Crafty because she crushed him and she didn't show up. She just had a nice little time. Had some me time.
What the fuck?
Had a little
is
me
that?
Time.
They promoted that Lacey and Asuka were still wrestling like today. Like,
they didn't.
Yeah, and nothing they do stops us from watching. So why would they care? No, yeah, for time matters. They cut it. It doesn't matter. It's just kind of an odd pay per view for the women. Like going into Mania, they didn't move any of the women's storylines forward.
Yeah, I guess they're gonna.
You know,
something that did happen tonight is we have a new U.S. champion in Matt.
Oh yeah, Matt.
That's what I like. You mean I choose the other name.
Matt.
Your U.S. champion, Matt.
Matt. We got a. It was a huge, hey big win for Matt. Yeah. I mean, whatever. The U.S. title is a meaningless title. But I
looks
don't know.
Cool though. It's one of the only belts I think looks cooler now than it did 10 years ago.
Yep. It looks cool. I like Riddle. I'm just kind of conflicted about his deal, but I don't want to keep rehashing that every time we mention him. Right. It's he's still a fucking good wrestler, and we'll see what they do with it. I don't know.
Yeah, I'll say something though. I'm also not conflicted. I do not like the way he handled that situation.
It was, I'm not conflicted about it.
I know you used it, but I'll instead of you doubling down, I'll just down and say that, he's not one of my guys. Right. And also, I also think outside of that, since I don't have to care like I used to on the indies, he's vague and getting vaguer. I hate his promos. I hate the dude thing. I don't care about his Evil Knievel gear tonight.
Dude.
Yeah. Look, dude. You know, I don't know, dude I was seeing a squirrel back.
Well, yeah, he's becoming a parody of himself that was a parody.
It was already a parody. It was never good enough for me. It was never good enough
Spicoli.
For me.
It's not, it's nothing.
Yeah, it's not, you're right.
I don't give a shit anymore. I'm done. And I talented. I liked him in the UFC, but he's got, maybe he could take some accountability in his life. I'd like him. But then on top of that, I would like him to do a full gimmick change. He's hit his ceiling with the dude thing, with the sand. I hate the sandals. I don't give a shit. I'm done.
Sandals are the only thing I like. The rest of that gimmick can go fuck itself. I will say that one of the worst vignettes I've ever seen in my life was him and Pete Dunne's bro journey across America or whatever the fuck that was. It was meandering nonsense, terrible waste of time programming. He's got charisma, but not enough to do something with. He just is not working for me. I think he's talented in the ring, but he seems like he's not that good of a dude. And I'm with Skylar 100%. So I'm not excited about this guy's reign, but we'll see what happens.
Yeah. Okay. And then
it was two chamber matches, a tag team match, and that was the main card. I mean, I don't know about the pre-show.
That was it. Yeah, I was
the pre-show
qualifying match,
and also Morrison beat. The Elias Mustafa Ali with Mace, T-Bar, and Slapjack, and Ricochet, the most disappointing man in wrestling.
Richard O'Shea.
Richard O'Shea. Yeah, so it was kind of a weird pay-per-view in terms of the whole show, in terms of this close to Mania. It was odd, but then also we got some clarity because the whole SmackDown Chamber was essentially pointless, right?
Yeah, I just don't get what they're going to do for Fastlane either. With you're going to have Roman and Edge is going to be booked. I just don't know what Fastlane, what that pay-per-view is even going to be.
You might not see Roman on Fastlane.
We probably might see a contract signing or something, right?
Right.
Right.
Yeah, something like that.
We'll see an IC title match at Fastlane, I guess. We'll see a U.S. title match at Fastlane, I'm sure. We'll see.
Maybe some women's matches.
I was about to say some women's action would be nice. Yeah.
I think what might happen, I'm just thinking, I don't know why this didn't occur to me now, just because we recorded right after we stopped watching, but probably Fastlane, Lashley, Drew, number one contender match, right? And then the winner faces Miz.
Probably. Yeah. McMahon's razor sounds.
Yeah, and then Drew. And then that
sounds about right.
And then we just see Drew Miz, which, the more I think about Drew Miz, the more excited about I am by it. It is some guys are so massive that they're so big. Drew is just so fucking big. It's Miz, Drew, you're they gotta start planting weapons. Miz has gotta go full.
Might be a stiff match. Might be a stiff match, by the way.
Right.
Could be.
It might not even be the last show. It might not be the last match on either night. It could even be the first match on the second night, or even a prominent spot on the first. Because I think they probably want to have some sort of women main event one at least the first night, and so you might actually see some street fight handicap, some crazy mania different style. The sky's the limit. Again, another reason to watch Raw.
Probably yeah, a so, ladder match a between Bad Bunny, Shane McMahon, and The Miz at WrestleMania.
Probably. I would say this. I wouldn't be surprised if Bad Bunny's like ringside or something. But but I would say this is that if we think about take a macro view on what we are seeing right now for the card, I think the seeds that we have planted are Roman Edge locked in. Well, that we could fully lock in, right?
Yeah, let's lock that in.
That's already,
and that is, and that is ending night two.
That's ending night two. Then I think we, and then we probably have. We're looking at Drew Miz, potentially, right? That's well, we can't lock
that's
that
what
in.
I think.
No, can't lock that in. Definitely can't lock.
I don't think Lashley's involved in that match. I think they go Drew Miz and they start. Those two guys. Then I think we're gonna see Bianca Sasha. That seems to be locking in, right? Can't lock it in yet, but
I think
that's fine.
I think it's almost locked in.
It's pretty close to locked in, but Bianca Sasha, and then Asuka, Charlotte.
I mean, Charlotte's always in play.
We don't have.
It might be like Asuka, Charlotte.
Asuka,
Charlotte could take it off of. You know what I would? Because Lacey's with Charlotte right now.
Yeah, Lacey's pregnant though.
Oh,
she's pregnant, right?
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they can't just unsplain that without some pretty heavy shoot programming. So I don't know what they're going to do about
it. I mean,
that.
So Asuka, Alexa would actually make the most sense.
We don't know what Charlotte's going to do.
I don't think – I think Alexa's going to be involved in just Fiend Bray. Fiend Orton.
Orton.
That's
Orton kind of,
that's
Fiend,
almost
yeah. – that's a lock.
With a lock in.
What?
That's a lock.
That's a lock, right?
We'll
and by the way, might
threat.
I say how excited I am that two of my favorite performers – have this like storied history together. Like it's one of the all time feuds.
It's like
of the
one
decade.
Of the longest running feuds. Yeah. When you think about it.
And it's so great because I love both those guys so much. I'm just so pleased about that.
I loved the thing about what do we call him? Fedora Bray? Yeah. The thing about Fedora Bray is that like his energy, I almost like that character more than Fiend. Like I almost as in terms of like how wrestling works, that character is like probably better suited for the long haul of pro wrestling, but he could never make it totally work. He could never make those promos make sense. It was all just like vibe and energy as opposed to like a clear cut vision. Whereas like the Fiend is a little more vaguer, but it really works. And you know, you kind of get it, right? And it's, he's like rehabilitated and you see the lore of him kind of avenging the failure of Fedora Bray, right? So it's like it all kind of works, right? And that's what literally they follow that. Like they have the burning house in the background. So it's awesome. But I really wish the Fedora Bray, there was so much you remember about that Orton Bray match from 33. That like the lead up felt so fucking cool, but made no sense. Remember, like Orton would like burn the house down, and then remember that match was like 6 minutes long with projections that everybody hated.
Yeah,
it was
weird.
Such a fucking the whole thing was so weird.
But that's the thing when you're dealing with Bray, and you're dealing with a guy you trust as much as Orton, you just say, "Hey, we're gonna take a chance." And it's actually really cool when WWE does that because they don't often take chances. So stuff like that. If we don't have stuff like that that are kind of maybe misses, we don't have, like, the Boneyard match hit. You know, we don't have Bray's match against Cena that's, like, a video package match. Like, you need to be able to give these guys the creative leeway to hang themselves with that rope sometimes so they could fucking knock it out of the park sometimes, which I think AEW is probably more successful at than WWE, right, because they have less to lose. But I think that Bray match with Orton, not one of my favorite matches at all. I did think it was kind of weird. And then I think Orton wound up winning it, which was weird.
Orton won it so weird because Bray won the title at Elimination Chamber.
Yeah. Right. It's just been weird, but I'm
off
cool
of
with
Cena,
them.
Who held it from Rumble to Chamber. you guys remember that. It was very odd.
Right. So whatever. I mean, you got to let Bray be Bray sometimes. And so I'm fine with that. Last topic.
Then we'll get out of here. Last topic. What do we do with AJ Styles?
I was just about to fucking ask that.
Right? Like, the guy is, he looked fucking great tonight. You know?
Could have won from when we were watching.
And that chamber got AJ back on people's radar.
I got it.
You know?
I know what to do.
I know what I want to do.
I know what to do.
I feel like you don't.
Is it Bad Bunny?
You start off night one, AJ Styles versus Finn Balor for the NXT title.
Oh, that's actually not bad. That's not bad.
I don't hate it. I don't hate it. I like that. I think that's good.
That's not bad. I locked that in. I locked that in as a good idea.
That's happening. Yeah, that's not happening.
Adam Cole and Adam Cole. You want? You know what? Honestly, if WWE had the bowl, if WWE had the balls, they do Adam Cole
again.
Finn Balor and AJ Styles for the NXT title in a ladder match to start off night one. If they had the balls, they don't have the balls. But that shit would
fucking. Don't see them putting NXT on. They did that like years ago from the Saudi flight, and it was the best Survivor Series for that reason.
I feel like Finn's gonna get a title match on NXT.
But Skylar, do you think that with two nights to play with, they might do an NXT?
Yeah,
game?
I do think that actually.
They almost got a lot to fill.
Because Dan, are they not doing an NXT takeover before?
I don't think they are. Right?
I think they aren't because it's two nights. I could be wrong, but
maybe there's matches on both nights. On within both nights of Mania, there will be probably two very prominent.
Which could be interesting. So that's maybe not dead. What I think AJ is doing is, because again, this is the business, maybe this is wrestling business. I think he's getting into fucking ship shape, getting into fighting shape. In the event someone breaks an ankle or tears a fucking pec, he's like, I'm here. Throw me right in that storyline.
He wore Taker colors tonight.
There's something significant about that. You think he's going to fight Taker?
That match never happened. Okay, I just want to tell you a couple things. I know I sound like a filthy mark here, but just fucking...
It's fine. Let it fly, baby.
If you mention Bad Bunny versus Taker, I'm going to leave the Zoom.
You're going to hang up? All right.
I'm hanging up.
Yeah. All right. I'll put the Sheets music on.
Just wait until it happens.
This is total mark shit, okay? Yeah. But okay, so... Michelle McCool posted on her Instagram a couple weeks back. She posted a video of Taker in his ring... with their daughter and she pinned him, right? But if you remember a few years back when he was training to come back against Cena at 34 and it was up in the air, he built this training facility just to train. It was a shack in Austin that he took over. It's back in there, which he still has it operational. The knees were taped up. He was in the ring. So I'm just saying, okay? Yo. He was in the ring. And so why would he train there?
You would mark the fuck out for the gong hitting tomorrow night. AJ Styles in the ring.
Not tomorrow. That shit's happening night one for night two.
That's something
that's
that
one of my guys booking.
I like that. I was thinking, are they going to do something at night one that feeds night two? If it's AJ Taker, wow. But
hey,
I just can't.
My mom was pissed off because I don't have a match. What do you think, Omar? It's just ridiculous. Gong.
God. I'm home eating my fucking barbecue, I'm looking like a million fucking bucks. How many more kids got bang out?
See me do that TikTok dance, do that TikTok. Boo.
So he wore Taker colors, which I think was intentional, but might be intentional to fuck with you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
But
he also, you could see his abs. Like, he's working out like AJ's been getting in shape. You could see he's sometimes a little doughy. Not doughy. He's never doughy, but you know what I mean. His body fat's a little higher. It's a little lower. He knows he has a match at Mania that he's excited for.
AJ
he
will probably be the
just
guy
the
that wrestles.
Just advocate for a quick second, though. Like they all get in Mania shape. It's
That's
not
true.
Like
I had that exact thought as I said that. That was my other thought.
You know what
I'm
my thought
with
is?
This one.
You know what my thought is? Because the way my fucking sick brain works, my sick brain is I'm like, here's what happened. He saw Edge. About the same age. Edge is looking like a million bucks. He's like, yeah, fuck that. Like, I got to look better than Edge. I got to get out of my game now. Because that's how I operate.
Could we get?
I see
like
a guy running. I'm like, I got to run faster.
Could we get an AJ versus another legend, like a Shawn Michaels kind of match?
Who needs it? Shawn Michaels is a huge
Shawn is not,
narc.
Shawn's not wrestling again. Yeah.
Now that Shawn Michaels has a shaved head, now that he's completely gone bald, he's got a shaved head, he's just like a poor man's Adam Pearce to me.
I said
hot take.
Open up night two nights. Night one, first match, you open AJ Ziggler. I think you just tear the fucking house down.
Why not? Killer match. Why not?
If you don't have something interesting for him, Ziggler probably will go in as tag champs against Street Profits, and they'll throw another team in that's like Aleister Black.
And AJ
like,
and Omos.
Tony Storm or something.
Maybe AJ and Omos win the belts. Why not?
Vince is going to look at AJ tonight and go, this guy needs a real match. Like, it's not.
You want to hear the worst booking, but just like something?
Yeah.
Almost turns on him and you see a David versus Goliath match.
So I was thinking like the only thing to do with AJ is like maybe fight Almost, but like, that's not going to happen, right? Like, that's not going to happen. I'm dying to see this guy get in the mix. Like I want this guy.
I love it. Almost he's gonna walk down the Mania ramp this year. I love that.
I love how we've named
as a valet.
Yeah, as a valet.
We've named like seven different logical scenarios, and they'll still pick one. That's not one.
What's
of those.
McMahon's razor? AJ wins the Andre the Giant paddle.
Yes, 100%.
Yeah, 100%. Is that the McMahon's razor?
Because Omos catched him in his arms like a little baby, and he rocked him back into the ring.
Could be.
McMahon's razor could. No, it's not like AJ Shane too. That's even too weird.
Yeah, no, Shane. Know. So that's another thing we didn't say that. That was the other match.
Shane Strowman.
They're Shane setting
Strowman.
Up Shane
they're
Strowman.
Teasing Shane Strowman. Yeah,
which is that's a perfect match for Shane.
I mean, I'm just so worried for Shane.
That's a perfect Mania match in my mind.
Perfect
right?
Mania match because I don't really give a fuck about Strowman. So why not throw him into a freak show match with Shane?
A Tampa Bay Lagoon match.
I just think that with Shane being Shane,
it's a fall from the Titantron match, and you're like, I wonder which of these two guys is gonna fall off the Titantron.
I just think he's gonna fold Shane up and like throw him in a trash compactor, and Shane's gonna be like, do it, hit me, kill me. Shane is gonna die in that ring.
Shane survived a helicopter crash. Shoot helicopter crash. Yeah. All right, let's get out of here, guys. We had a fucking great talk.
I got a quick announcement, Dan.
What?
I should tell you. I got to tell you something.
All right.
Just real quick, maybe Bobby versus AJ. That's McMahon's razor. Anyway, that's McMahon's razor.
Bobby AJ.
Okay. Lashley versus AJ. Anyway.
That's good. Oh, Riddle AJ.
Riddle AJ. That probably could be something.
Yeah.
Angel Garza versus Montez Ford for prettiest.
I feel like Riddle getting AJ Mania. That feels like rewarding bad behavior. You know what I mean?
I hate it.
Yeah, we don't like it. But he's holding gold, so why not?
He's nowhere near AJ level. Fuck that.
I agree, man. Fuck Riddle. I mean Matt. I mean whatever.
I'm not just being because of the thing. I mean, What? Who are you?
I've always been critical of his on-camera stuff. His performance stuff just doesn't click for me. Everyone really likes to mark out about him, and I think he has potential, but he's not putting it together for me. Oh,
or AJ Brock.
I don't think we're getting Brock, but I'd love to see it.
That'd be babyface Brock. Go.
So,
well, you had something to say. We got to get out of
here. Yeah, look, this past week, you know, was a pretty big week for the Comedians of Wrestling podcast, I think. I'd like to think that I made a couple new friends, that's fans friends. They're friends, from the group. If you guys don't like who I am and what I bring to the table, you know, I am the Comedians of Wrestling champion. I did beat Dan and hit Tullo a little bit. And maybe
we were having fun for a little bit.
I'm just saying it was maybe a little bit unscrupulous, but I did what I did because I love the pod. I love being your champion. And I think I'm doing my best to elevate this title. I've been trying really hard. It's not like I'm out here doing jack shit in Hawaii. Like, I'm out here, I'm courting The Rock, I'm putting a stable together, I'm building things. And yeah, look, The Rock saw my promo and he regrammed it. Okay. That we got over 400,000 people saw that and saw me raise this title and say, I'm the Comedians of Wrestling champion. I think that means something. And I'm really proud that I was able to do this for the podcast. And I hope that I keep making you guys proud. And I just want to let you guys know I'm going to keep doing bigger and better things for this podcast. And I'm working on some things. I'm gonna set some things right. I'm gonna right some wrongs. That's all I'm saying. So I have an announcement this week. I have some rights to wrong. Trust and believe, guys. I love you all. I'm proud to represent.
So your announcement is that there's an announcement coming?
I mean, this is a wrestling podcast, is it not?
Yeah, that's a great point.
Oh, I'm sorry. Do people not announce that they're gonna announce things? I thought that's kind of like what we do out here.
Yeah, that's true. That was my bad. But I guess what I meant to say is, does that mean you're? You're coming to the main
I'm saying
pod?
I'm not. It would be putting the cart before the horse for me to at this moment announce anything officially. I'm just letting you guys know something is in the works. I'm gonna set some things straight, and I'm pretty excited about it. So be on the lookout for that. It might be coming as soon as the next episode of this pod, but announcements will be made.
Okay. All right, everybody. All right, so we'll look forward to that. Everybody, thanks for tuning in. Skylar, thanks for coming by. Tullo, thanks for doing the pod. Shebs, We'll look forward
Bad
to it.
Bad Bunny versus The Miz, WrestleMania. And, let's go.
Yeah, everybody, thank you. This podcast is brought is free. It's brought to you by
the fucking tunes.
It's brought to you by the Patreon. Go to patreon.com/comedianswrestling. Get access to our bonus episodes. We are like two or three or four patrons away from our patron push to 20, where we have new Cow Arts going to drop. The Cow Movie Club will come back, where we dissect wrestling movies to an unhealthy degree, movies with pro wrestlers in them. And also, every patron will get a new sticker based on the new Cow art. And check out our bonus, our main episode coming out on Wednesday night / Thursday morning, and the bonus episode on the Patreon, dissecting AEW and NXT to an unhealthy degree, comes out Friday a.m. for patrons at the $5 level. And the next Kalzoop Thunderdome will be Fastlane, whenever that is. All right, everybody. Hey, man. Yeah. Like, cheers up.
I don't know. It's all right. I've been dealing with some things like every human being.
Let's go. Put
really
it up.
Didn't sleep much last night. I'm sorry. That's fine. I just think I need a little me time. I just think I need a little free time. Little break from the shows and the bus rides. Yeah. Last year I had a breakdown. Thoughts telling me I'm lost, getting too loud. Had to see a therapist and I found out something funny's going on up in my house. Yeah, started thinking maybe I should move out. You know, pack my car, take a new route. Clean up my yard, get the noose out. Hang up my heart, let it air out. I've been searching. What does that mean, Nate? I've been learning. Grabbing my keepsakes, leaving my burdens. Well, I brought a few with me. I'm not perfect. Looking at the view like this concerns me. Picking up the cues, right? I'm quite nervous. Hating when I lose sight. Life gets blurry and things might hurt me. It's probably gonna be a long journey, but it's worth it though. Cold world out there, kids, grab your coat. Spend a minute, I know, now I'm back to Rome. Looking for the antidote to crack the code. Pretty vivid, I admit it, I'm in classic mode. Don't need pity given to me, but I can't condone. Talking down to me, I'ma have to crack your nose for cracking jokes. I'm looking for the map, the hope, you see that? Been making a whole lot of changes. Wrote a song about that, you should play it. I get scared when I walk on these stages. I look at the crowd and see so many faces. Yeah, that's when I start to get anxious. That's when my thoughts can be dangerous. That's when I put on my makeup and drown in self-hatred, forget what I'm saying. Where the beat go? Oh, ain't that something? Drums came in, you ain't see that coming. Hands on my head, can't tell me nothing. Got a taste of the fame, it upon my stomach. Throw it back up like I don't want it. Wipe my face, clean up my vomit. OCD trying to push my buttons. I said don't touch it, now y'all done it. I can be critical, never typical. Intricate with every syllable, I'm a criminal. Intimate but never political, pretty visual. Even if you hate it, I make it feel like you're in it though. You call me what you want, but never call me forgettable. Leave you deep in thought, I can never swim in the kiddie pool. Waited, I've been thinking the cinematic is beautiful. And I don't know if I'm making movies or music videos.